up now, man. Don't give it, give it up. Hey there guys, welcome back to Let's Play Pirate Warriors 3. We're going through the final costumes. Three videos left, counting it down. So, Robin here has her own set of crossover costumes, the first of which is Kaihime from Samurai Warriors, otherwise known as just Kai, which is a bit weird, because that's my sister's nickname. I'm not a big fan. Yeah, it's that this I get to see it in this game. Not that I dislike my sister, but it's just a little weird. Kai is thought to have been Yujinaga Narita's daughter, who is famous for her beauty and her acts of personally riding into battle. Though heralded as a brave woman, modern historians wonder how many of her accomplishments are real, as they might be fictional stories from the Edo period. Her heroics are not mentioned in notable historical records, making her actual name and existence unclear. Very interesting. So let's head down here. We'll just clear out these islands one by one. Whitebeard, sure, let's do it. Let's fight him. So, yeah. I don't think there is a Kaihime in, I think Hime means just lady, though, right? So her name is just Kai. So they went with Kaihime as this translation, which is fine. Oh, hey, we can give her actual upgrades. Maybe that will help, you know? Let's use something that we've never used before. Because, like, we have ones that we just... because we don't need the A ranks anymore. So let's see here. Restored when allies come to help. Let's look for some three-level ones that would change things up. I guess I could show off the, life automatically increases at a fast pace. That'd be super nice. And snacking. With those two, we are basically invincible. And, you know what? Let's go with, Sniper's Wisdom. Yeah, so basically, no matter how much damage we take, not only do we heal automatically, but now we also even have the ability to just, normal enemies will drop items, which is a really good power-up. And it's interesting, because that was one that you got right away in Pirate Warriors 2. Like, that's a base level one, but I guess it was just so powerful that they had to nerf it, you know? And I think it's just a chance thing. It's not an actual, like, 100% guarantee that you're gonna get it. So, Jozu here. Okay, so he was confirmed to be appearing in Burning Blood, but for some reason they went with another translation of his name, meaning he's in it as Jaws. Which is admittedly, you know, yeah, it is a proper translation of his name. You know, it's not like it's wrong or anything. You know, whenever there's a U at the end of someone's name, it can be like translated out and it would still be right, because it's not a sound, it's just like the end of a name without a consonant there, or yeah, without another vowel there. So you know, his name being Jozu, because it's like whatever English language stuff. But no, it's like I don't know, it's because it's Tecmo Koei versus Namco Bandai, so you'd think they would just stick with one translation, but sadly that is not the case. I mean, whatever. It's not much you can do. But, well, a lot of games have that issue, though. Where it's like, you know, when it's multiple translations by different companies for stuff, they'll just name it differently. And it's like, really? Come on. And I just... you'd think there'd be some consultation with it, but... oh, well. And you can still call them what you want to call them. I mean, I know in JoJo, for example, they would, frequently, the character names that are changed, they just say whatever and do it to whatever they want. This was not the move I really wanted to use. At least we get a good look at it. Oh, we actually got Brooke! And it was a one-hit KO. Nice. And now all these dudes are ours. I don't know. To be fair, you know, it's if you call it something else, if in, like, the game it's listed as something but you want to call it something else, I guess there's no big deal. And, of course, what they actually say will be kept the same. It's not like they're going to actually change how their names are said or anything. You know, it's like, no, they'll still call them the same thing. So, audibly, it's the same. It's just in writing, so. Then again, that leads to the Rufy scenario, which we don't want. So, whatever. It's a good costume. I like this one. The booby tassels are a bit out there, but you know what? They've made worse decisions. Whitebeard is up here. Let's go grab him in the crotch. Oh no, he's over here. Why was I going over there? Okay. Vista versus Whitebeard. Probably not the best matchup. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay, so people have told me that there is one combo I didn't use with Whitebeard. And because of that, oh my god, also weird, just like straight up killing him too. I didn't use a certain combo with Whitebeard. And people were saying, oh yeah, if you use this, it's super good. And it can clear out rooms. And I'm like, okay, if I didn't know about it, it can't be that good. But I used it, the one that everyone's telling me to use, and it was the most... It was amazing. It's his four lights, then a heavy, and you can charge it, and it just unleashes giant projectiles to both sides that can clear out an entire room and keep going until they hit a wall. So, it's a little amazing. It's really good, you know. So if you're playing as him, use that. I didn't use it in my playthrough because I think that might be a new attack, considering I've never seen it before. Alright, this guy's next, Morgan. Morgan's such a character that, like, I wonder if they're going to bring him back. Apparently, he does appear in background elements for some stuff, like as a Marine again. But, I mean, you know, it makes sense he's not the most used character. His whole ability is, I have an axe for a hand and a jaw of iron, which, to be fair, could lead to some neat stuff, but at the same time, there's better, much better stuff that's out there that you can use with him, or use, you know, other characters for him in his place. Zunamax, good. Let's take out Buggy and Mr. 3 here. There's a lot of enemies in this place. Like, it's actually really surprising. Defeat Buggy and protect Wapole, but I don't want to protect Wapole. He's the worst character in the game. I hate him. And I think everyone kind of agrees he's one of the most annoying ones because of his whole going in the ground thing. He reminds me of Zant from Hyrule Warriors for that reason of, like, he just becomes invulnerable at times, and it's stupid. Oh, are we actually going to get him? I don't know. I think he might be going. Oh, no. Well, we lost our ability first, so it doesn't even matter. Try and get another partner ability going. Oh my god, we're taking like no damage from him though. I love it. Oh, we're so close to beating this game, guys. Once I'm done this, I'll definitely be moving on to something else. It's, you know, it's been a long road for sure. I'm still amazed that this gets views. I wouldn't have thought that this would get as many as it does. It's a good thing, you know, lots of One Piece fans on this channel, which is good. Again, I will be looking at Burning Blood when it comes out. Although, I don't know, single player probably only, and then like with some multiplayer stuff with friends, I probably won't do online stuff. Similar to what I did for JoJo, just because I don't really want to do a whole, I don't know, whole giant thing like this ever really again. It's... Okay, yeah, no, I'm definitely gonna rethink about doing entire game Let's Plays again. Like, I guess for some RPGs it's fine, but man, I feel like this is one of my longest going, you know, Let's Plays. Mind you, some parts are a lot shorter than others, but still. Oh, well, hi. I found you right here. You've got no chance, you are already dead, sir. I would do the Japanese quote from Fist of the North Star, but I actually don't know it. I've never been a big Fist of the North Star fan, honestly. I only know really about it from the crossover games, and I remember I played the Fist of the North Star Ken's Rage or whatever, the basically Warriors game for Fist of the North Star. I played that with a friend. Well, not really played it, but he was playing it at his house, and I was there with a couple friends. And I just remember seeing people's heads explode, and I was having fun. But the game itself was actually incredibly unremarkable, and apparently is one of the worst crossover Musou games ever. Like, you know, there's some that, because other than this, there's like the Dynasty Warriors, Gundam, that is, and Arslan and Hyrule Warriors. And for the most part, I heard they're all pretty good. But no, I've heard the Fist of the North Star ones are actually really terrible. And to avoid those. So, that's good, because I'm not a Fist of the North Star fan. So, that's fine. Let's just try and clear out this room a bit before we use our level 2 or whatever. We can also do this and clear it out, because it speeds us up, which is probably the best buff. Oh my god, it's such a good buff. It's like, it's honestly the only buff you really need. I mean, the extra attacks are also good, but I can't really find out what they are. God, that one's amazing. Where even is Whitebeard right now? He's over there. Ow. That exploded. Did, like, no damage to me. Oh my god. He's just staying super sturdy. That's amazing. Okay, I love that one, though. The hands a bunch of times. It's really good. Let's avoid that. Yeah, look. He's just taking it like a boss, man. That's awesome. Okay. Oh, you're gonna try that? Well, I'm gonna try this. Please tell me it'll work. Oh my god. But of course the camera just won't let it happen. Wow, that... You know what? There's only one thing to do. Do it a second time. Oh, no, it got the random dude. Well, he's dead. Goodbye, sir. Sadly, I can't finish this in the utmost of styles. Oh, here we go. That's pretty stylish, too, just throwing him around. It's actually such a fun attack, too, because it, you know how it hits everywhere. I love it. Perfect. Okay. Are we going to get any coins, though? That's the question. And, come on. Are we... Okay, we got more of that, which is good. Aw, darn it, we did not. Okay, well, pretty soon we might have to start redoing the islands to get more. That's fine, though. Let's head down here. And who's next? It's Xingcai, and we're going to switch over to the Xingcai costume, which I think is actually pronounced... CSI, that's what it says on Yomi. It's CSI. Okay. Sounds good. Is an original character who debuted in Dynasty Warriors 5. She's the fictional interpretation of Liu Shan's wife, who was Zhang Fei's youngest daughter, making her Zhai Bao's sister. You get that? Good. Together with her childhood friend Guan Ping, she is portrayed as the future of Shu. She's one of the newcomers to be cut in the following title, but returns in Dynasty Warriors 7. Interesting. Before 2012, Koei Title separated the Chinese characters for her name and called her Xingcai. Her given name is now properly localized in the games as one full name. Very interesting. Let's go. So this costume is a lot more icy. I like that they're not similar color schemes per se per character. Like, you don't get two red ones or two, you know. So this one is another, like, it's a bluish outfit. And, we'll get to see when we get into the battle. I mean, it looks good. Don't get me wrong. It's all the Dynasty, well, all the Warrior crossover costumes really do. Again, customized a bit. And glasses, too. How could I not? Okay, this is already off to a wonderful start. Oh, geez. I guess I should show off that there is a block button. You know, I can block. Which did nothing there for that attack. But it's okay, because we're going to get him. So we have to, this is another prevent from reaching mission. Oh, he's tough, actually. That, or I think he's just not... A character who, oh my god, Frankie, I forgot about that as your ability here. He's a tough matchup for Robin, I'd say. Oh, but man, I forgot about Frankie's, like, drop-in abilities. Oh, Jabber's our partner. Like, look at this. Okay, no, not that. But, this. That's amazing that that's just a thing that he can hop in and do. That's good. That's really good. You defeated Xingcai, so now let's just go around room to room, get this, at least semi-liberated. It's crazy, as you get to later levels, oh man, that looks so good. You soon start to learn that, like, the main sort of purpose of the game, which is to liberate all the, all the areas, you start doing it so fast that eventually it just stops being your main goal, you know? Okay, so Jesus Burgess is here. So let's go get him. I do like how this level's laid out. I think it's the good mix of, like, tight, but also open, kind of. Like, it's big, but the tightness actually makes it easier to at least get around, so I like that. I don't like levels that are too big and crazy. This one is definitely a nice balance of them. It's well designed. Oh, how do I get in there? Oh god, I have to go around? Guess so. I don't even know what the purpose of that is in this one. I lied. I dislike this. I have to go all the way around. I swore there was a door there. Oh my god, this is a long path. Okay. I mean, at least we get some good looks at the costume, you know? It's good. Good design. It's like it's a little more armory, for sure. You know, it makes sense to be, you know, wearing armor. Here we go. Okay, so first off, we'll use this to get rid of enemies in the area. And then, we'll use grab on him, because we can. Where is he? Oh my god, let's see this. Please work. Aw, it sucks that it zooms in on their model sometimes, because then you can't see it. Who would be next, though? Probably down back here. Sucks a little bit we don't get customized portraits for all the costumes, but that's kind of a thing that's been in every Warriors game where it's like sometimes you get them with extra portraits and sometimes you don't depending on their costume. It's a weird thing that they have to, I guess, choose between, you know? Because they're pre-rendered, they're not using just, you know, they're not using the actual character model, they're just pictures that they made, which you think would make it easier, but I guess not. Oh, there he is. This way. Or maybe not. Yes. Trying to get all the way down there, which I won't let him do. Please take a right. My right. You are. Good. Oh, good. Kizaru's here. Let's go. Oh, you could feel that leg. That leg is there. Oh my god, he's already almost dead. He's gone. See ya. Okay, let's go get the other two then. Aw, man, it still feels good to just attack groups of enemies. Like, when there's a big group of enemies, you're in for a good time. Which is weird, because you normally don't feel that with big groups of enemies. Wow, we got them both. That was brutal. We're way overpowered for this, and I'll take it. I love it. I know some people would say there's no challenge, but I prefer just the constant reward sort of system of you're amazing, you're doing it, you know? We've heard that exact thing already once. I like Robin as a character. I've gone through this all before, but honestly, she's one of the most interesting ones for just her, I don't know, her kind of everything. Sentomaru has retreated to Marine HQ. Well, see ya, Sentomaru. Whoa, where's Whitebeard? Whitebeard's an enemy up there, I didn't even know. Like, it's interesting, because when you're talking about, like, what each of the Straw Hats bring... Oh, Shanks is here. Where? Oh, he is. Interesting. I've never had him invade yet, so it'll be interesting to see what happens. First off, let's take down Whitebeard. Where is he even? I don't even know, man. There's a lot of enemies in here, though. Like, when you talk about what each of the Straw Hats bring, I feel like Robin brings a lot. Like, a lot of seriousness and a lot of, you know, character interaction stuff. And I think she's definitely one of the ones that was one of, like, the best ones to be added. And I really hope that whoever is the next one, whoever that may be, because there's a couple that people think it is. Apparently there's one guy from the latest arc. Well, no, there's a couple from the latest arc people think it might be. A lot of people think that, what's his name? The shark guy whose name escapes me. Oh my god, what is going on? The whale shark, fishman karate dude guy, you know exactly who I'm talking about. What's his name? But you know who I'm talking about. He might join, because he said something about, oh yeah, I'll join you after Luffy. After the whole incident with Big Mom, which is what's happening right now. Oh my god, I'm going to go super mad, because I was even just talking about him with a new watcher of One Piece recently. And how she loves him. And I'm like, yes, you should, because he's awesome. Oh, you know what? I'm just gonna not even try. It's not worth it. I see his face in my mind, but I am just not able to right now. Please tell me I'm not the only one who has this happen often. You know, maybe it's because I'm going between numerous games and stuff, and it's you're still alive. Of course you are. Your Shanks. Wow. He went... We were throwing him while he was charging his haki and was able to do it. Come on. Oh my god, we got him into an area where he shouldn't be. And it was awesome. Good. There's a lot of dudes here for him. Just use this quickly. Oh, that lasts so long and I love it. Okay, so I have a feeling Ivankov's gonna appear again and this will be our final bout with him. Where is he? Look at this tech. Where is he? Right up there. Got it. It's a good thing they always talk after they appear, because when a bunch of enemies appear, I actually have a really tough time finding out who it is, you know? So I'm happy one of them will always talk, and you can just straight from there, you know, you'll know. Okay, nice. Oh, we got him. Oh my god, we're doing a lot of damage to him. Like, oh my god, this damage, though. Ooh, that hurt. Okay, gotta finish this in style, though. Oh, please work. Please grab who you should. You did it. Amazing. What an attack that it only hits one person. I can't believe that's actually a thing in this Warriors game. Perfect. Let me get a nice look. Oh, that's good. That's good. That's a good costume. I like it. Fur's nice. Nice fur, for sure. For sure. But, I mean, all the shoulder pads are really good, though. I love it. It's actually really good. Very classy, too. Not sure about the hair thing, but you know what? I've seen weirder. Are we gonna get it? Gold coin? No, darn it. Okay, that's fine. We broke one character's level limit at least. Right. So, thank you all for watching, guys. And next time, we still have two more character costume extravaganza thingies to do. So, we'll be seeing you then. Ciao.